Keith Dunn-Fernández here with another TGI Sunday. Oh, and look, it says that TGI Sunday is with Matt and all these other people. You know, I hate my life sometimes. I thought I fixed that. Oh, crappity. Well, anyway. I did everything. You know, I've been so worried about doing this on YouTube that I forgot that I should change that at the bottom, and, well, at least it doesn't say anything about what the name of the game is, so that's good. It's Ether One! And I'm just gonna leave that down there, because I'd have to restart the whole stream, and that'd be a whole other kettle of fish. Stinky, slimy, fishy fish. Fishy, fishy, fish, fish, fishy. That was for all of you fans of the Pythons. Okay, so we're going to press X. Now, I would like to continue game, yes, please. Because I first tried to play this game initially when it came out on the PS4, and I got stuck because I got lost in my own head and didn't just do the simple thing. So I've done the simple thing, and I have continued, but I played a little bit further, and I wanted to stop because I didn't want to go too far. I wanted to share this with the stream today. Because I like that pinwheel down there.
Our sole purpose this evening is to track the memory and pinpoint its location so we can cleanse it of any disease present. Everything you're seeing in front of you is a visual environment pieced together from our client's subconscious mind. Barren wastelands or an abstract painting reimagined. It's all completely tangible. All I can see are brain scans of tissue degradation confirming my previous diagnosis of dementia. Both are incredibly important if we are to succeed and understand our client's needs. Now, if you just give me a second, I'll have some more details for you.
Yes, please.
Feel free to explore in the meantime.
Now, see? Doesn't that look like a map? It probably is. Boing, boing. You know, there's a whole... Hiya, Shawnee! Hi, Sean! I love you, Sean. You're one of my favorite people on the planet. Now, the thing about this game is, you start in look, you can run. I know, everybody's gone to the rapture. Never gonna get over that. Secret run button. You start the game, actually, in an elevator, and you go out into an office, and you have to sign in, and then they give you a card, and you have to take the card and go, ooh, pretty, nice lighthouse. You have to go down to the basement, so you go down to the basement, then you get down there, and there's a chair. And the chair won't work until you figure out how to put kind of a fuse in it. So you figure out which fuse it is, and you put it in there, and you get in the chair. And then, never mind. And then, pretty. It's all really pretty, actually. Look at that. That's just gorgeous. So Massachusetts. So, you have to... figure out that puzzle, and then when you get in the, chair, this thing comes down over your head, and then you end up here, which is where we are. I like that zoom. I like that zoom, right? It's a lot better than the, zoom for another game that I just reviewed that I did not like at all. Because that's stupid. Now, let me see something real quick, because I've sort of been on a tirade about reticles. So let's look at the options. Can I get rid of that little dot? No, apparently not. Yeah, okay. Nope, that's fine. This game's premise, Shawnee? I have absolutely no idea. And that's part of the fun, apparently. I went on psnation.com before I started this stream to see if we had a review of it or anything, and there's nothing. There's literally nothing. It had come out on PC. What I can tell is, from what I've gleaned so far, now I've just walked in a circle, that there's a kind of Assassin's Creed thing where you go into somebody else's head. Now, whether or not you're supposed to fix their memories or not, I think that's probably part of it. Because of what we just heard this woman say. But as for there being a premise, you know, I've no idea at all. I think, and I kind of really dig that, because you can just go into this blind and you know, The Witness is about puzzles, right? You know that going in. The next game I'm gonna, the bonus game I'm going to stream at 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, Layers of Fear. Well, it's right there in the title, isn't it? I mean, you know, you're going to crap your pants being afraid. This is called Ether One. And I don't know if... What is that? I don't know. I like not knowing what that is. It's kind of rare, because there's so many spoilers. The internet is a thing, and Pinwheel Industrial Tin Exports Plummet. All hopes on U.S. export deal. Pardon me. So, I'm not really sure what the premise of this is, and I like the idea that I get to find out as I go. I see it's a radio. Then, now what? You know what? Let's do a little quick refresher of the controls. Interact. Cancel. Crouch. Teleport. To case. Jump. Examine item. See, I needed to know that, because that's what I want to do right now. Read item description, blah, 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 blah. Okay, great. Well, I am cramming on the touchpad here, and it's not seeming to make a difference, so I guess there's just a radio there. Apparently, we all know what radios are. Gas masks. But they are very colorful, aren't they? Wow. Wowie wow. Yes. There's a note there. Hello? Nope, can't read it. I pushed every button in the button pushing thing, so. Okay, let's see what's going on up here. I'm back to the beginning again. You're killing me. There's this whole sort of walking simulator, right?
Please indicate that the central focus of this memory is located below you, in an old abandoned mine known as Devlin. Entry 95D in our client's memory journal indicates that an accident occurred affecting them in a meaningful way.
Well, yeah. If you're in a mine collapse, I would assume that that would affect you in a meaningful way. Okay. See, I'm not the guy that ever goes exactly where they tell me. Neither should you be. Neither. Oh. Okay, we got a thing here. I have no idea how to solve that, because I haven't been playing long enough. Ooh, we have lots of choices here. What I can tell you is that, the game that I'm going to stream at 2:00, because this is a bonus stream day, which has not come out and will not be out until Tuesday. It's a pre-release stream of a game called Layers of Fear. Yeah, Shawnee, it does look pretty. Was für? What the hell is that? Was für is German for what? What is? What for? Was für? There's an umlaut over the U, in case you ever want to spell it. Oh, Lord. Please don't tell me that I have to go back and, like, solve some puzzles to get the thing with the stuff and the junk and the... That's just me, making up music. Oh, cripes. Now, the corkboard being empty, I did not know that you wanted that. But yeah, it's terrifying. I have not played very much of it for review yet because I wanted to save my reactions for. That's gorgeous. That is such great work, actually. I wanted to save it, a lot of the gameplay for my stream before I then just trudge right along, right ahead. And, I mean, I've written a lot of the review already, which I think I spoke about on Slack privately with the other reviewers. And they were kind of like, well, how can you write a review without playing the game? Just because I wrote 800 words already? Dude! That's going to be one sentence in the review. I overwrite everything. I really do. And, thank you, Shawnee. But I overwrite everything. My husband looked at, what I had written so far. And he was like, you should write a book. You really should write a book. Oh, that's something new. Music. Yeah, you begin to wonder if you missed something up here. Yeah, so he, but that's just what I do. I overwrite a lot. I write impressions. When I begin to write a review for a game, I write impressions. Interesting. I write all the impressions that I have before even touching the game. Oh, how much is edited? Oh, Lord. John. Oh. I probably cut 1,000 words out of my review for, This War of Mine, the Little Ones. I probably cut 1,000 words out of it. Because, for one thing, I was really upset by the game. It really pissed me off. And, I kept repeating myself, for one thing. And, so when I cut and pasted everything into the format for the review, I butchered it. I cut so much out of it because, you know, I realized that some of that stuff was junk that was personal, that didn't have anything to do with actually the review. And for that review, I enlisted the help of Ben Palmer, because I knew that I was getting too political and going a little too wacko. And I was like, hey, Ben, now here's what's awesome. I am, like, pretty far left, not all the way crazy left, when it comes to politics. And Ben is further right than I am, but he's also not insane. So, and I suggest everyone do this. Wait. Everyone do this. If you have a conservative friend and you're a liberal, talk to them. And actually get their perspective on some stuff, because that's what I had to do with that review for This War Is Mine, The Little Ones. I consulted him, and I sent him a bunch of my writings and said, help me out here, because I think I'm going crazy. And he was very helpful, and he gave me a lot of advice about how to frame it. He never told me what to say. Of course, can I climb this? No, apparently not. He never told me what to say, and he didn't give me his opinion because he hadn't played it, but okay, so yeah, Ben is awesome and amazing, and should be beloved by everybody. He's really awesome. Okay, so I'm assuming that I have to get through this. But my problem is that I don't seem to hook on anything. Yes, Ben is good, peeps. And I don't know how this just happened. Is this the... Where am I? This is awesome. So I have been... Apparently, I've been in this person's head. That looks like a toilet seat. And... couldn't get anywhere. So... what have I done? I've come back to, what am I wearing? I can't see my feet. I sound like an astronaut. Now, someone has been here recently because... candles! Pretty. Now, yeah, this game is so... this is kind of the opposite of the issue that I... Well, it's not an issue at all. But this is, strange in that you have the reticle, quote-unquote, the dot in the middle of the screen, right? And, for layers of fear, I turned it off, because I think it's, baloney, because whenever you pass over the center of the screen, you get something that tells you what you should do. In this game, I'm not getting that at all. And, see, there's something else I have to do. And I keep jumping, because the controls are... I don't know what did that. Okay. Did anybody else just see that? When you hit the triangle button, you... Oh... you end up back at where you were. Oh, Okay. Well, this is kind of a three-dimensional map space. That's cool. Ah, 1944. That's very true. Okay, well, now I know where that's going. Toilet! How many games have toilets in them? Very few. I'm assuming. I think. And there's a shower. This is fascinating and I once lived in a house. I am not kidding you. I would not lie. You walked in and this is exactly the same setup that you found. It was ridiculous then, and it's ridiculous now. You had to go up from the living room, and then you could go to the bedrooms, and go down this side to the kitchen. It was in Evansville, Indiana. Marie Hebenstreet was a friend of ours then. Mark Davis was my boyfriend at that time. Rick Farmer. Everybody, I'm going to tag them all on this and say, look at this! Just so they can see what ridiculousness that was. Ugh. And it's still ridiculous. And no, I don't want to go that way. I want to go this way. And I want to kick that over. Okay. I'm getting violent. Ah. Ugh. Well, let's. No. Sprint R1. Yeah. Oh. Okay. Interact. Cancel. Crouch. Teleport. The case. Oh, okay. That's what the triangle thing was doing. Jump. Examine item. Read item description. Lamp restoration. Raise lower lamp. Pause game. Huh. Okay. Yeah. Shut up. I know what it actually is. Huh. You know, I really like this game just up until this point. But I don't think it's the fault of the game. I think it's something that I am not quite getting. And I've looked at the controls, which all seem to make plenty of sense. And now here I am again. Life is strange, isn't it? No, can't get in there. I keep coming across all these letters that I can't read, and I'm annoyed by the fact that I can't read them, because clearly I'm supposed to be able to read them. Oh, look! Just keep hitting buttons and eventually something will make sense. If you're lucky. That was the square button, by the way. Gamers. I need to ensure that I remember the lock combination to Devlin's side entrance, but the warden banned any of us from writing it down. Miners eat from metal plates. Don't forget. Miners eat from metal plates. Okay, clearly that is meant to be a kind of pneumatic device that you should be able to figure out. Is that M-E-F-M-P? Is that, and there's nothing wrong with it. If it is, I don't have a problem with varying ways to solve puzzles. It's just that, what? And, do I have to write that down? Are you telling me as a gamer, again, yet again, this is a new thing that's happening along with walking simulators, is that now, again, like you had to back in the SNES days, and even as far as the GameCube days, you have to go and get a piece of paper and a pen or a pencil and write down the hints so that when you come to that, are you kidding me? Why isn't this just in-game? I'm not talking about trying to make games easier. I'm just saying, it's 2016. I shouldn't have to get a piece of paper. Blah! I got your paper right here, bitch. Look at that! Now that I know that it's the X button, I'll be darned. As I'm sure you're aware, my client, Mr. H. Smith, no, really, is intent on offering you a particularly generous buyout of the Harvey & Co. Limited Enterprise. We would like to propose a meeting between parties and solicitors. No kidding. They'd be better off without you, but anyway. On the 15th October in our offices in Devlin to discuss a potential acquisition of assets and trade. Be under no illusion, Mr. Harvey. We are fully aware of your current financial disposition, probably meaning they know that he's broke, and are incredibly interested in rectifying the situation for you. Yours sincerely, Mr. J. Dawkins, business solicitor and consultant. Yeah, I got some news for you there, Dawkins. Blow me. Oh my. Look what happens when you figure out what button to push after already playing the game for 45 minutes. Ooh. I'm just not sure that reading these things is... What secrets does the lighthouse hold? Ask Chloe. You're mining, Warden. Apparently we're in the UK. I did not know that. But now I do. Every time you go around this area, you'll get this nice music. Okay, so now I should, what, look for things to read? Is that helpful at all? And am I going back? Now I'm going to go down. I don't know what's happening. But that's okay. You don't have to know what's happening. You have to figure it out. Hence... gaming! Oh god, I'm such an idiot!
I borrowed the air compression manual in order to make repairs in the mine, and I left it down past the blast doors.
Steve, my secret lover,
has warned me so many times about being forgetful. I just hope I can get it back before it gets lost forever. I can't afford for any of my wage to be docked this week.
Dan.
Howdy, Creepy Crawly. PS Nation is doing well.
Ooh! Look at that crap! Oh my. Oh, I didn't need to collect them. Yes, please. Yeah, I'll have that instead of that. Not so worried about the raisins.
It's worth noting that if you feel an item might be useful later on in your journey, and you have no use for it now, you can always store it in the case and collect it at any time.
Oh! Now I'm a little confused. Yes. No! I don't want to change one for the other. I want them both. I want them both. Bastards! Like, I'm going to take a pipe with me instead of... Okay, so... Are you telling me that I need to go here... It's interesting how you have to try and figure this out. But what if I want the pipe? Now I'm not going to quit. No. There was something here about, teleport to case. Yeah, but how do you put things in the case? Ugh. You know what? I really do like this game. The problem is that they could cut a lot of this bullshit out by just telling you how to put things where they fucking need to go. How about telling me that my case only has one spot? I mean, that would work. Then I would know that. I don't know that, and I'm assuming. See? Oh. And then I can't have that. I can only have a wrench. Okay, so you can have a wrench or a pipe or any number of other things that you can pick up. But, of course, you don't know what you're going to need in the future. So, God forbid they allow you to have an actual rucksack or something that allows you to... Ugh. And, no, I don't want your damn raisins. All right. Well, I'm just not going to take anything then. Hold on. Wait a minute. Having said that, I think I might need a wrench and... Oh, God. I'm going to run around everywhere. Over here. And down here. And down here. Nope. A wrench? A wrench? But how do you... Ah. No. No, I don't need to crouch. Crouch. But how do you use it? Stop it! Huh. Maybe if you have it on you and you hit the... Oh, Christ. How long does this have to go on before you actually figure out how this shit works? Yeah, so this is an issue. The game should actually tell you how things work. That's just my opinion. Clearly. Isn't that pretty? Look at the water. That water animation is really beautiful. And the game is really beautiful, and it's... It's great, but I just don't understand not explaining the control scheme. That just doesn't make any sense to me. And I mean, I would, yeah, no direction. And I would totally get it if. If stuff started out really simply and you... But that's not how it goes. And what you end up with is just getting lucky. Hitting the right button. Choosing the right thing. Okay. I'll take it. Instead of the wrench, I'll take the beer. But you know what? When I pick it up, then how do I use it? Spanner. See, I told you it was British. No! So, there's really no way to... I mean, I'm even using the D-pad. Nah. Ugh, can't make it. They've hamstringed themselves. They spent a lot of time, clearly, making this gorgeous game, and I just don't understand why they wouldn't also include some kind of intelligence for how to actually play it. Because otherwise, they're only hurting themselves. You know, people will look at the game, they'll be like, oh yeah, this is gorgeous, I can't, nothing works, how can I make this work? Oh, fuck this, I'm not going to play it. And they'll tell their friends, nah, you know what, don't play Ether One. Because it's just frustrating, and, you know, there's The Witcher 3. And, a whole bunch of other games that you can play that will not piss you off like this. Everybody's gone to the rapture, is that what you're saying, Creepy Crawly? Because this is, that, that game will give you instructions. Everybody's gone to the rapture. There'll be something on the screen, and it'll say, move it this way, move it that way. And no, I completely understand what you're saying about coming to a game blank. And I love that idea. I love coming to a game completely blank and needing to figure it out. However, when you go to the controls, again, when I do this and go to the controls, interact, cancel, teleport, jump, read item description, lamp restoration, raise lower lamp, pause game, and sprint. But it doesn't tell me how to use anything. I mean, it does say interact, but... shut up. Oh, Ethan Carter. Oh, okay. I streamed Ethan Carter, actually, during the blizzard, and I didn't stream it so much as I just got drunk and talked on camera with Ethan Carter in the background. Yeah, I can change him out, and that's all I can do. I do need to play more Ethan Carter, and I love these games, but... You know, I just don't get it. Because I want to play this more and enjoy it more and all that. And the game itself is a barrier to my doing that. It's pretty annoying. I mean, look at the art. Look at the game design and everything. And it's lovely. It's just so disappointing that... Apparently, after, I don't know, a lifetime of playing video games, I'm not smart enough to get what they want me to do. I mean, I'm somebody. I played Galaga at the mall before I saw Star Wars in 1977. I did. With a Pepsi in one hand and a thing in the other. Yeah, and time. And time, too, Creepy Crawler. I mean, you know, we have time here, but we don't have that much time. I've been wandering around for 47 minutes and done not a lot. Besides shoot my mouth off and go, oh, look, I can pick up a letter. However, what I'm going to do now is end this stream and set up the next. The next stream will be not dissimilar to this in that it is first person walking around. But the game is called Layers of Fear. It does not come out until next Tuesday. However, the embargo of streaming it ended today. So I'm going to stream it and talk a little bit about it as I go. My review is not done. It won't be done till sometime next week. But yes, that game... I'm really liking it because of the way that it is sort of, it's like the movie Insidious in a way where something happens and it just puts your spine tingles all the way up. So, I'm going to end this stream now and, begin another one. Layers in about 10 minutes. Okay. Thanks, and thanks, Creepy Crawly! Bye-bye.